All right, this is the Waju coming to you with another quick lesson. First and foremost, I'd like to give all praises and glory and double honors to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai Bashim, Makar Kadash, double honors to the elders, apostle, great millstone, pushing this word, should be faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. Shalom to the Akim that's scattered through the four corners of the earth, preaching his word truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. And shalom to the Akim that be like unto the speckled bird, preaching his word truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. I say shalom to y'all. And the title of this lesson is going to be The Meek Shall Inherit the Earth. And I'm going to bring out the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 5. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. And when I look up the definition of meek, it means submissive and patient, I believe. I just looked up the word about a minute ago, the definition of it, you know, right? And that meek is talking about the Israelite man, the Negro, Latino, and Native American. And the speckled bird Israelites that makes up the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, us men in the Lord that's in this truth, like the scripture says, study ourselves, show ourselves improved, you know, with the scriptures, and definitely going out there preaching week in, week out, you know, humble and meekness, you know, the Lord loves that, you know, he loves to see his man meek, bold, you know, standing up for righteous sake. So, you know, that's why you see the men of the Lord out there, the prophets, the men of the Lord, you know, they out there standing boldly for the name of Yahweh Bashim El Shah, which is Yahweh, is the Heavenly Father's name, and Yahweh Shah, his son, who you ignorant calls Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shah, Hamashiach Yahweh Shah, the anointed in the ancient Hebrew. So, you know, that's why, you know, bringing the scripture out, you know, blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth, right, you know. The men of the Lord, that's out there prophesying week in and week out, you know, doing sit-down lessons, you know, out there preaching the word, the true gospel of Yahweh Bashim El Shah, like it's supposed to be preached the right way, the right doctrine way, you know, and the men of the Lord, great millstone, starting with the elders, apostles, the great men of millstone, and the mighty man, elders, you know, in the Akim, in the brotherhood, for the top rank leader, and all the way down, in that bottom, in that order. You know, that's why, you know, the Lord set up men, the mouthpiece, the prophets of the man of the Lord. That's preaching his word truthfully and sincerely, you know, and Lord willing, you know, those brothers in the Akim and the elders, you know, hopefully they get that crown on their head. And for the next kingdom to come, you know, Jacob's rulership, you know, it's like it says in the scriptures, Esau is the end of the world, Jacob is the beginning that followeth, you know, one, the next rulership and kingdom, you know, hopefully the men of the Lord have those crowns on their head and sit next to the Heavenly Father, Son, Yahweh Shai, you know, and hopefully, you know, we be those men, Lord willing, you know, for us to keep on, continue to push forth this word. You know, meek and humbleness, count our blessings, you know, thank the Most High and His Son for waking us up to this truth, and thank the elders, apostles for this truth as well too, you know, the Most High set up, great men of the Lord, they have us elders, the brotherhood, the top generals in our camp, you know, in the brotherhood, on down in that order as well too. So, you know, I'm gonna bring out the scripture again. This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 5, King James Holy Bible. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth, right? You know, the meek, patient, and submissive to the Lord, which is Yahweh Bashim El Shah. You know, we make patiently, you know, suffer for the righteous sake, for the Heavenly Father, His Son, Yahweh Shah. You know, bless all the ones that are meek to inherit the earth, to the kingdom to come, Jacob's rulership and dominion, you know, not Esau, Edom's kingdom. Because like the book said in Micah 2:10, this is not our rest and Esau's kingdom. So that's why we push forth and strive to continue to push this word truthfully and sincerely, you know, preaching the true gospel, you know. And the true gospel is being brought out. You know, this word is fire. Esau, Edom can't stop the truth to be of the truth, you know. And hopefully the Israelites that's out there still don't know that you're Israel. Hopefully you could be able to wake up, you know, in the times that we are living in. That's why, you know, the Most High sent his prophets out to warn and wake up his people, you know. Because, you know, while the door of repentance is closing, you know, still got time to repent. Come back to who you are, the law, statutes, commandments of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua. Come back to being a holy people, a righteous people. You know, a set-apart people, because you know me, holy means separate, set-apart people. You know, like we're supposed to be. So, you know, if you have a hear, let him hear. If not, hey, keep it moving, you know. But, you know, I just wanted to bring out this Matthew 5 and 5. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Right, you know, bless all the men, especially waiting for Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua. Breaking out this word truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely, you know. And then, hope this was edifying. So, through the Spirit, I just wanted to bring out this lesson. You know, it was on my mind most of the day today, so I just wanted to bring out this lesson, you know. So, the meek shall inherit the earth, you know, starting with the men of the Lord, you know, of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushua. The lost sheep of the house of Israel, so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and the speckled bird is a light as well, too. You know, the meek shall inherit the earth. You know, this is for the Israelites, you know, the Israelites only and the speckled bird Israelites only. This truth really pertains to us, you know, not the other nations. You know, you do have other nations that's, you know, got the bloodline of Israel. You know, but the other ones don't, you know, which is the other nations like Moab, Esau, Edom, Japhet, Elam, other nations like that. You know, they can't inherit the kingdom in the earth if your bloodline doesn't go back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, or the seed of your fathers, you know, etc. I'll roughly paraphrase. But other than that, I hope this was edifying. I would like to give all praise, that's some glory, and double honors to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem, Rakakadash. Double honors to the elders, apostles, great millstone, Christmas word, truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. Shalom to the Akim that be like unto the speckled bird, Christmas word, truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. And shalom to the Akim that scattered through four corners of the earth, Christmas word, truthfully, faithfully, strongly, and sincerely. And to then I'll say shalom.